example of rampant and open fraud being committed by government officials. You can see that this particular official altered official court documents in order to get the outcome at the court hearing that she wants to get, which would put the young man Kadar in jail the rest of his life. What you're looking at is the striking out of factual information by the military commission convener, Susan Crawford. As you can see, her initials, SC, are there. On April 24th, 2007, when she sent the package to Guantanamo Kangaroo Court, Ms. Crawford realizes, of course, that once that word or other suspected Al-Qaeda terrorist is included in the charges, then that means that Kadar might have done nothing whatsoever at all to hurt or kill anybody. So she, wanting the decision of guilt, simply stroked it out, put her initials to it, and sent it on down to Guantanamo. So now the official charges have been altered by someone who obviously wasn't at the battle, by someone who has no direct knowledge of the events at the battle, but who simply wants a particular outcome and will adjust the facts as presented in the charges and the charging description to conform to the outcome she wants. As an American, it's pretty embarrassing, pretty disgusting. The other part of it, which is quite a bit less embarrassing and disgusting, is that they are apparently allowing a gentleman named Lane Morris, who has a $102 million civil judgment against Kadar for an eye injury. They are allowing him to testify for the prosecution against Kadar. And since he hasn't collected his money yet, if Kadar is found innocent, it's quite likely that this particular prosecution witness will be losing his rights to that $102 million civil judgment. And yet, the American justice system is going to put him on the stand to try to nail some put some nails into the guilty coffin verdict of Kadar. It's unknown whether the defense attorney is even aware of the $102 million civil judgment. It's unknown whether the military commission is aware of it, and it's unknown whether, even if they are aware of it, if anyone in these kangaroo courts has the right to impeach a prosecution witness. So that's the secondary aspect to this charade.